This is Lisa from Happy Stamp, and today we are going to be making this Easter card right here. This Happy Easter comes from the stamp set Celebrating You. So I have Happy Easter, and then on the inside I have lots of love. All right, we're going to be doing, this is with the Loveliest Layers decorative masks. So we are going to be doing some masking on the cardstock here. I got this color combination from Patty Bennett. She had done a bunch of color combinations, and I just really liked this one for an Easter card. Whenever I think of Easter, I think of purple and green. I don't know why, but I do. So we're going to be using these layers right here. All right, so I have a piece of fresh freesia, and it measures 5.5 by 8.5, and we're going to score that at 4.25. Let's see, I have two pieces of basic white that are 3.5 by 4.75. And I have two pieces of parakeet party that are 4 by 5.25. And then I have an envelope that for the we're gonna do a little masking on the envelope as well. Lost my words right there. So all right, so let's do our masking first. And I'm actually going to do the masking of the card and the envelope at the same time, so I don't have to get everything out again for the envelope. So first we're going to use this one right here. And I'm gonna put it over this way just a little bit, because this is where I want the sentiment to kind of be over here. So I'm just going to move the basic white over there. I'm taking some removable masking. It's removable labeling tape. I got it on Amazon. But it also helps to keep your labels or your masks in place as well. So this is a good size roll. I've had this for years. All right, so first I'm going to take the Fresh Freesia and Gorgeous Grape combination. I'm going to use the lightest first, so we're going to use the Fresh Freesia, and I have a blending brush with its name on it here. So we're just going to, and I kind of start off a little bit and then go on. What I mean by that is start off the mask and then brush onto the mask, so you don't like get this big glob of ink in one spot, is what I'm trying to say, but the words just are not coming out the way I want them, which happens a lot. So you can make this as light or as dark as you want, but do keep in mind that we are going to be putting some Gorgeous Grape on top of here. All right, I think that's good. So we will close this one up. Give this a little wipe so I don't get it mixed up. All right, then I'm going to reuse my Post-it tape here. And then to clean these, you can just take them to the sink, or you can just use a baby wipe to wipe them clean. All right, so then I'm going to take this one, and these aren't, they really don't match up perfect, but they're pretty darn close. All right, so get that back down there. Oh, and I already forgot. I'm sure you're saying, don't forget about the envelope. So we'll do that real quick. And I'm just doing that like over here in the corner. And I'm not even doing the whole thing. I'm just doing a little bit of it. Make sure that I don't get any ink on the parts of the envelope that I don't want. And this is the same thing, post-it tape. It's just a smaller size. So I will put that on there. My fresh freeze up real quick. And I'm just putting this down in the corner of the envelope. Now we will take the gorgeous grape. Get that over here. Gorgeous grape. I have another blending brush. And this is going to put the gorgeous grape layer on. So I hope everybody got everything they wanted from celebrations. It's all over with. Usually we used to have it for 3 months. Now it's only on for 2, so it's kind of a little weird. All right, so there is that. Let's take this off here. To do the same thing over here. So I'm just going to slide the mask under here. Maybe it goes on this way. Thought it was just going to be easy and slide right under there, but oh well. There we go. Just want to make sure. I don't want to get it on my other project here, so I'll tape that off. And tape that off. So that I got a little bit on there, but that's all right. All right, so move that out of the way. All right, now we're gonna do the leaves, and we're gonna do this set first. So it's gonna go like this, I believe. Yes. So that's going to go over here. I can get this up. All right. So this is going to go right like this. And really, there's no right or wrong way to do this. You do it any way that you feel looks good. And for this, we are, oh, and I got some up there too. Oh, well. Okay, I'm going to use the Parakeet Party first. So don't do like I did and mask over top of your papers. Ha ha ha. This is the Parakeet Party, which we get to have around for another year. We are thinking we are going to be having a color refresh because we have a couple of colors that are in some designer series paper that you can get right now, but we can't get the... We don't have them available yet, but we're thinking we're going to get some new colors. All right, so I'm just going to put some of this on here. And this is Parakeet Party. It's pretty much just it. What was left over on my blending brush. And sorry if you are getting dizzy from my blending. I do apologize. All right. And then the last part are the veins of the leaves. I think I'm just going to do this one first. And that's just going to go right here. And we are going to use some Granny Apple Green for that. And we definitely want to put some Post-it tape on here, so that we do not get that all over the place. All right, so there's the veining, here's the envelope, and I will just take a sand eraser to the pieces that I accidentally got ink on. All right, so this is going to layer on here. Like that. So I'm going to take again some of my Post-it paper here and my Granny Apple Green. I'm going to ink that on top. Done with these. I'm going to get rid of them so I don't get ink all over myself. And then there is your flower. And then, like I said, just take those either to the sink or a baby wipe and you'll be fine. This is just a sand eraser that I got on Amazon. And it just, if you, as long as you don't do it too hard, it'll kind of just sand off, yeah, sand off the layer that you accidentally got ink on. You can still see a little trace of it, but not very much. All right. There is that. Now, what I did is I took our basic black Stampin' Right marker on the really thin edge. And I just kind of drew squiggly lines and dots all around. So I did it freehand, and however you want to do it, kind of just drug it and just tried to be really organic with it. Except I still really have to concentrate. All right, so there is that. Now, I am going to decide which way, if I want to put, yeah, I think I am. I'm just going to do as it was done in the card. Where is my black? I'm going to take my Memento and the Celebrating You stamp set. And like I said, I'm using the Happy Easter. But you could turn it around and do the Happy Easter up here and just do it this way. And then just stamp the Happy Easter up there. Maybe I'll just do that. Just to see how it goes. To bring this way down so that I can see it. And then I'm just going to hold it for a few seconds just to kind of let the ink, a little crooked, but not too bad. I can live with it. So there is that. There. Yep. All right. All right. Then I'm going to take one of the pieces of Parakeet Party. I am using the stencil that is coming with, or that is here now, with the online exclusives. It's one of a trio. And it's got little stars in it, it kind of looks like. So I'm using that one. And I'm going to run that through my embossing machine. So I want a 1 and a 4, and then the 3D embossing folder with the paper. And then we'll run that through. Like this. Lots of nice texture on there. All right, and here is my piece of fresh freesia. Still haven't found my stylus. It's around here somewhere. Okay, so we're going to score that at 4 1/4. Folder. All right. Then we will adhere this with some glue. We want to use the glue because there's lots of nooks and crannies in here, and the glue will get right down in there and cover these. It looks like I cut my paper wrong. All right. Let's see. 4 1/4. It should be 4 1/4 by 5, and I did it 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So I'm going to pitch that because I don't want to get, I will get glue all over the place. So these should be 4 1/4 by 5, not 5 1/4. Oh no, it should have been 4 1/4. Now I am going to have to cut because it should have been the other way. All right, let me get some pretty peacock paper here. Maybe right here. All right. We will use that for a scrap. So we need 4. By 5 1/4. 2 times. So this is 4 by 5 1/4. All right. Let's try that again. All right, so I'm going to bring my washing machine back up here real quick. Luckily, I have it sitting right here. So I have my 1 and my 4. And that goes in there. So that looks better. All right, more glue. Front of my card. There we go. Much, much better. Take some more glue and we will glue down our front panel here. Make sure I get it on the card correctly. All right, there we go. Then I can take my other piece of Whisper White right here, and we will use the let's see, what color did I use? I used Gorgeous Grape, and we will put lots of love right here on the inside. You could always stencil yourself another flower on the inside if you wanted to. I may do that, but I'm not going to do it right now. You've already seen it twice. And then lots of love. Take my seal and I'm just using my seal on this one because this doesn't really have any dimension on it, so Or it doesn't have any dimension on it. All right. And then this can go on the inside. There. I just, for some reason, lately my Tombow has been like, I can see it through the white paper. I don't know. And maybe it's just me. I don't know. I'm just smooshing the glue on the front to get it all nice and adhered. All right, then I'm taking some of the opaque adhesive backed gems, and I have some fresh freesia and gorgeous grape here. So I am putting quite a few on here, or I did. We'll see how this one goes. And so there is that. So I think that is it. I might have to put a little more glue on my corners. My corners don't want to stay down. All right, so here's the one that I just did, and here's the one that I did earlier with the sentiment in the opposite corner. And then here is the envelope that we made to match. All right, so if you have any questions, please feel free to leave me a comment below. I'll be happy to answer them. All supplies can be purchased through my online store at happystamp.stampinup.net. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Bye.